In the previous topic, we had studied about significant figures and how we add, subtract, multiply, divide, and how we round them off. This topic is the last subtopic in uncertainty in measurement. When we have the distance between two points, point A and point B, and point C and point D. Okay, now let's assume a person has to walk both these distances. Okay, but the issue is, this is given in centimeters and this is given in meters. Do you think we can add them directly? Because probably not, right? So because these units change, because these units are different, you can't add two values which are beside these units. So there is something called as dimensional analysis, which is done to make sure that we are able to convert the units, and following that we will be able to calculate or do whatever calculations that we want to do. So in this method, I'm going to take an example again. So let's take 20.5 meters. Okay, and I want 20.5 meters to be converted to centimeters. So here we are converting meters to centimeters. Okay, so as we know, 1 meter equals to 100 centimeters. Okay, so we will write this as 1 equals to 100 centimeters divided by 1 meter, and this is called the unit conversion factor. So basically, we are just taking the interrelation between the meter and centimeter and writing it equals to 1. So 1 equals 100 centimeters divided by 1 meter. Okay, so this is called as a unit conversion factor, which is responsible for converting one unit, the quantity represented by one unit to a quantity represented by an other unit. So when we want to convert 20.5 meters to centimeters, we will be multiplying it with the unit conversion factor. So into 100 centimeters divided by 1 meter. Here your meter and meter will get cancelled. That's the best part about this. Your units have to get cancelled. So if your units don't get cancelled, means there is something wrong that is happening. So 20.5 meters and this m and this m meters are getting cancelled. Centimeter stays, which gives us 2050 centimeters. Okay, so always remember, in this method we are first taking the general conversion between the two units and equating it to one, and that's called the unit conversion factor. This is then multiplied with the quantity that you want to change along with the units. The units will get cancelled. So to understand this better, let's do a few problems. You can try to do it along with me. So the first problem is that you have a 3-inch long piece of metal. Now I want to convert this to centimeters. Now the conversion between 1 inch equals to 2.54 centimeters. Okay, now remember, you need to convert this inch to centimeter, which means you need to have the centimeter as the numerator and inch in the denominator. Because of that, 1 equals to 2.54 centimeters divided by 1 inch. And this is going to be our unit conversion factor. So I will just multiply. So 3 inch will be equal to 3 inch into 2.54 centimeters divided by 1 inch. So inch and inch will be cancelled. We will be multiplying 3 with 2.54, which will give us a value of 7.62 centimeters. Okay, let's take another example. Now, a jug has 2 liters of water or milk, whichever, and we need to change this. We need to convert this into meter cube. Now, 1 liter equals to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, we can't, so there are various ways you can do it. We can do this in like one step, but I would prefer if we take 1 equals to 1000 centimeter cube by liter. Okay. The reason I would prefer to do it as two steps is because you're just learning this right now, but I'm sure you can do the conversion in just one step as you get familiarized with this. So we will start with conversion of liter to centimeter cube. Okay, so 2 liters will be equal to 2L into 1000 centimeter cube divided by 1 liter. So this L will get cancelled. Okay, this is the unit conversion factor, right? So I'm just multiplying it. So you get 2000 centimeter cube. Next, we have to convert centimeter cube to meter cube. Okay, now the centimeter cube to meter cube conversion is 1 meter is 100 centimeters. Okay, now remember that the unit that we want cancelled has to be in the denominator. Here, a centimeter has to be in the denominator, which means 1 will be equal to 1 meter divided by 100 centimeter. Now, here it is a cube. So, I will hold this. Okay, so this becomes our unit conversion factor. Now we will take the value 2000 centimeter cube into 1 meter cube divided by 100 cube centimeter cube. Now I cancel these two values. Okay, and after calculating, you will get the answer as 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Because 1, 2, 3, 3, 3 is, it's a cube root, right? So it'll have 6 zeros. So there'll be 3 zeros left, which comes out as 10 to the power minus 3. So here, you can do it as two steps like I did it over here, or if you are able to, you just have to multiply this unit factor along with this one. So you just multiply these two and then you get the answer. The reason I did it in two steps is because this is the first time you're probably learning this method, and it just made sense to simplify it instead of complicating it in the beginning itself. Now the last one, here we will be doing it as one step instead of two or three. Here we are going to be converting 2 days to seconds. Okay, so 2 days to seconds. So 1 day has how many hours? 24 hours. Okay, so the unit conversion factor for this would be 1 equals to 24 hours divided by 1 day. See, here day and day will get cancelled, so you don't have to worry about it. Now, 1 hour will be equal to 60 minutes. So, here the unit conversion factor, 60 minutes divided by 1 hour. Here, hour and hour will get cancelled. The next is 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. So 1 equals to 60 seconds divided by 1 minute. So the ones in boxes are all the unit conversion factors. So when I want to convert 2 days to seconds, I will multiply 2 days into 24 hours divided by 1 day into 60 minutes divided by 1 hour into 60 seconds divided by 1 minute. Leaving the math part aside, here you have day and day getting cancelled, hours and hours getting cancelled, minutes and minutes getting cancelled. So all the units which are not necessary, basically the final unit is the only one which stays, and this gives us a value of 172800 seconds. So the second problem, I'd done it as separate individual steps. In this problem, we had done it as just one step. Okay, so here the dimensional analysis, you have something called as the unit conversion factor, which is basically multiplied with the value along with the unit you want to convert. Okay, the best part about this method is the fact that the units tend to get cancelled, leaving the units that you require in the end. With this, we finish uncertainty in measurement. Do check out the other videos that I have done on uncertainty in measurement if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next topic, which is going to be about laws of chemical combination.